Vaibhav, in today's session, we are seeing subdued momentum in most of the major equity indices as well as major currency pairs. And if we look at the Euro-USD after yesterday's slide, it has entered into a consolidation phase and it has been hovering closer to 1.225 for a larger part of the day with the underlying bias still remaining bearish. So in today's session, we will see if the Euro-USD has topped out from the near-term perspective, and we will see how we can trade in these changing circumstances. So let's get started for the day. If we consider the data docket for the day, earlier in the day, we got the unemployment rate for the month of November, and here there is slight decline. And now for the month of November, the unemployment rate has gone down to 8.3% compared to the prior month reading of 8.4%. The improvement is there, but I think that's largely because of the higher base and some people getting the jobs back, but not much of a dramatic improvement on that count. And even in month of December, we are not likely to see much uptick in the employment generation as the COVID pandemic is still raging in the larger part of Europe, and as a result of that, the economic activity is not recovering as fast as expected earlier. Moving on to the North American trading session, we are scheduled to get the United States as well as the Canada's employment figures. And for the United States, we are likely to see the non-farm payrolls rise by around 70,000, and this will be coming on back of earlier growth of 245,000 in the month of November. And this figure is of course well below the prior reading, but still the job addition is there, and this will be the sixth consecutive month of jobs being added after sharp fall experienced in the month of March and April. And this expansion in the hiring is likely to be sustained, but the pace of economic expansion has now largely plateaued, and because of that, we are not seeing much growth in the new jobs being created. And if we compare the pre-COVID figure for the employment, then compared to that, we are almost more than 9 million jobs lower for the month of December compared to pre-pandemic month of February 2020. At the same time, the unemployment rate for the Canada is also going to release, and here the full-time jobs change are likely to be in the vicinity of 40,000 to 50,000, and for the part-time employment, we are likely to see the figures being a lot lower, and there might be some decline on that count. And the overall unemployment rate is likely to be around 8.5%, so not much of a change is being expected in the Canada's job market. Now moving on to the technical segment, first we will consider the technical outlook for the Euro-USD, and then we will see what's happening in the dollar index. Now let's get started with the Euro-USD technical outlook. This is the daily time frame chart for the Euro-USD, and after making a high closer to 1.235, the Euro-USD has moved sharply lower. And one of the key reasons has been the renewed strength in the dollar index, and the strength in USD has pushed the euro lower against the USD, and that is also being reflected in the chart. And now from short term perspective, I think the euro USD has more or less topped out, and we are likely to see the consolidation phase extending with the near-term bias now gradually shifting to the bearish side, and in due course of time, even the lower levels closer to 1.215 can be expected. We are not really far away, only 100 pips from those levels, but it is not going to go away sorry, go straight away, and it is likely to spend considerable amount of time in range bound manner. So for us, it will be challenging to trade, but then we are also likely to get many of the scalping opportunities, though not many swing trades opportunities. But from short term perspective, we can indeed try to exploit this situation to our advantage. So if we look at the 4-hourly chart, we have this regression curve which has flattened to some extent, and now it is even inclining on the lower side as the price has moved in the lower band of this regression curve. Whereas if we consider the pivot point series, the price action is taking place in the bullish half, as the price action is above the central pivot point, but it has struggled closer to this first resistance of this month's pivot point series, and after making this high, it has gone down. And in the near term, as I was saying while explaining the daily time frame chart, also we can expect the decline to deepen towards this 1.215 level. Here also, from the pivot point series perspective, this level is likely to act as the key near-term support, and this is the price zone which can be targeted if we are looking for the selling opportunities in the Euro-USD. So in today's session, I would suggest that we have to watch out for this SMA formation. We have this SMA convergence taking place closer to the 1.23 zone, and on the higher side we have this confluence of 50 and 100 SMA, and then on the lower side just closer to 1.227 we have this 200 SMA also. Now in today's session, we had this sharp sell off where the Euro USD decline had extended towards even 1.222, but from those low levels some retracement has taken place, and I think this will be good opportunity to take advantage of, as long as price action is hovering closer to these 200 SMA, we can be hopeful of further decline taking place in the Euro USD, and in anticipation of that, we can indeed look for fresh short selling opportunities closer to this convergence zone of 50, 100 and 200 SMA, as the price action is lower than this 200 SMA in due course of time. The 50 SMA is also likely to cross below the 200 SMA, and that will have one more major confirming factor for us, and we can be more confident while taking the trade. So in today's session, as well as for next couple of trading sessions, these consolidation phase lows are going to be important, and we can utilize the price zone of these three crucial SMAs to act as our desired entry point while keeping the stop losses just a little above these 1.23 mark. I think the near term trading is likely to see the Euro USD lower than 1.23 zone, and if we don't really see any sharp move on the higher side, and if the consolidation phase forces the Euro USD to largely remain below this 200 SMA zone, then I think we can indeed look for the fresh shorting opportunities where on the lower side the price zone of around 1.215 can even be targeted while keeping the stop losses just little above 1.230. If our entry is anywhere close to 1.225 to 1.226, I think the risk reward ratio is also likely to be closer to 1:2, and that should be good enough even from the conservative perspective. Now moving on to the dollar index. In yesterday's session, we had talked about the dollar index seeing the upswing, and that's what we have observed in a larger part of today's trading session. And the outlook remains fairly similar, and the only thing now is to do is look for the optimum entry and exit points to make sure that our stop losses are fairly sharp and our target prices are wide enough to cover the risk which we have to take while looking for the trading opportunities in the dollar index. So looking at this consolidation phase, price formation in the dollar index, I feel after looking at yesterday's sharp up move and then in today's session, it has been able to sustain those gains and it is hovering well above yesterday's closing price. So that also gives us one more reason to be optimistic for the dollar index, and the near-term price zone of around 90 is going to act as a crucial marker for us who are looking for scalping opportunities in dollar index. So looking at the lower time frame charts of 4 hourly and the pivot point series, we have to consider these flattening of the regression curve, as was the case with the Euro USD, where the regression curve had flattened. Here also the similar story is playing out, just in the opposite direction. Now in case of the dollar index, we are seeing this consolidation phase happening largely above this first support of this month's pivot point series, and the near term support has kept the dollar index above this support zone, and now the price action has also moved above this middle band. It has moved in the upper band of this regression curve, and in due course of time that opens up the possibility of dollar index climbing toward this central pivot point of this month's pivot point series, which is there around 90.5, and that is the price target which we can look for when we are looking for fresh trading opportunities in the dollar index for today's session. If we want to figure out the optimum price levels, I think the prior swing high and this confluence zone of 50 and 100 SMA, which are converging closer to the 89.7 levels, are going to be of crucial importance to us. And if the price action remains above this 200 SMA, then in due course of time, these SMAs are likely to cross and hold above the 200 SMA, and that will have the effect of convincing more and more market participants of the changing sentiment in the dollar index, and that might push the dollar index further on the higher side. And keeping that in mind, I feel we can indeed look for the buying opportunities in the dollar index anywhere closer to 89.7 to 89.75 should be good enough. Of course, after due consolidation and on the lower side, the stop losses can be kept anywhere closer to 89.50, and that risk is likely to give us the reward, which is going to be more than twice. And if we happen to be right, the price zone of above 90.5 can also be reached in the dollar index for the risk of around 30 to 40 pips. I think the target price can be kept closer to 70 to 80 pips, and that also brings us the risk reward ratio of 1:2. So here the key is to get the entry right, and for that we will have to wait some time for this consolidation phase to get over. We will then need to see if there is some positive momentum, the momentum on the long side in the dollar index, and then only we will think about getting involved anywhere closer to 89.7 or just little above that, while targeting the price zone of around 90.5, and stop loss is going to be closer to 89.3 to 89.4. And I think, as I have already said, the key is going to making sure that the risk reward ratio is in our favor. So that's it from my side for today's session. If any of you have any query or any idea to share, you can write to me in the comment section, and I would be more than happy to take the discussion forward. Before I sign off, I would also like to remind of the risk associated with trading in the financial instrument, and one should be careful while using the information provided. Have a fabulous day ahead and equally fabulous weekend. See you on Monday. Goodbye.